स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? दिस इज सुमन अहलावत एंड वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल. सो टुडे मींस वी आर गोइंग टू कंप्लीट द क्लास 12th बायोलॉजी, बिकॉज फ्रॉम चैप्टर 1 वी हैव फाइनली केम टू चैप्टर नंबर 16 एंड टू टॉपिक्स वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड, चैप्टर दैट इज एयर पोल्यूशन एंड वाटर पोल्यूशन. एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज, एज यू कैन सी, today's topic is about solid waste. So here, anything that goes out in trash, what is solid waste? Anything that goes out in trash is called as solid waste. We know all these very well. Okay. So what do we do with it? Open dumping and burning. What do we do with the solid waste? Either we will do open dumping and burning. Open dumping and burning, and then sanitary landfills. Or we can do the sanitary landfills. What we can do with the solid waste? Either we can open dump them, or we can burn them, which will lead to air pollution obviously, or we can do the sanitary landfill. Solid waste is dumped in open area and then burnt, but the waste is not completely burnt, and then it will be a breeding ground for rats, flies, etc. So as you can see here, in open dumping and burning, the solid waste is dumped in an open area. And then it is burnt, but it is not burnt completely, and then it will be the breeding ground for rats, flies, etc. Here it will not burn completely. It will not burn completely, and then it will be the breeding ground. It will be the breeding ground for rats, flies, etc., which causes the various diseases. Okay, we all know this. In sanitary landfill, we will compress the trash. First one is, we will compress the trash that is solid waste. We will compress it, okay? And then we put mud or soil on compressed trash. We put mud or soil on compressed trash. Compressed trash. Okay. Suppose, first of all, we will choose an area which is far away from the cities for the purpose of landfill. And that area should have low lying area. Okay. So suppose this is a low lying area. Here we have dumped the waste, and then we'll cover with the soil. Again, we will dump the waste, we will cover with the soil. Again, we will dump the waste, we will cover with the soil. Again, we will dump the waste, we will cover with the soil. This is soil, this is waste. This is soil, this is waste. Okay, clear? So, for doing landfill, we will choose an area which is far away from the cities, and that area should be low-lying area. Okay, like any sort of dumping area, low-lying area should be. Okay, so we will put the waste, cover with the soil. Put the waste, cover with the soil, unless and until that area will come at the same level of the land. So this is the sanitary landfill. So we can do two things. We can do open dumping and then burning, but the waste will not burn completely. Then it will lead to the breeding ground for the rat, flies, which causes diseases. Or we can do the sanitary landfill. We will compress the trash, and then we will cover the trash with the soil. Before these two methods, it will be better to separate the trash. Before we use these two methods, it will be better to separate the trash. Okay. So whatever the method you are using, open dumping and burning, or you are using the sanitary landfill, you are using any of the two methods, before that it is better to separate the trash. Okay. So how we can separate the trash? how we can separate the trash and into what categories we can separate. We can separate biodegradable waste, okay, the waste which is biodegradable, then the waste which can be recyclable, then the waste which we can reuse, recyclable, and then the waste which is non-biodegradable, okay. So now non-biodegradable, reduce the quantity. We should not use non-biodegradable. We should reduce the quantity. Okay, and in spite of non-biodegradable, we should use paper or jute bags. We should use paper or jute bags. We should use paper or jute bags. Okay, biodegradable, these are used for composting. So waste can be separated in three categories: biodegradable, which we can use for the purpose of compost. Then recyclable, which can be recycled. Non-biodegradable, first thing is they should be used less as much as possible, and we should use paper cups or jute bags in place of non-biodegradable waste. Okay, so this is the method of decomposing the solid waste: either open dumping and then burning, and then you can do the sanitary landfill. Now we are going to study about hospital waste. So next category is hospital waste. It is also the part of solid waste only. Next one is hospital waste. Hospital waste is also called as biomedical waste. It is also called as biomedical waste. Okay. What we can do for the hospital waste? We can do the incineration. We can do the incineration for the hospital or biomedical waste. Okay. Then next is electronic waste, e-waste, or we can say electronic waste. What happens in incineration? The waste is allowed to burn at a very, very high temperature. Electronic waste, we can do landfill and we can do incineration. We can do landfill and incineration for the electronic waste. Okay. Developed countries export half of their e-waste to developing countries. See here. Developed countries export half of their e-waste, to developing countries. They are exporting their electronic waste to the developing countries. In developing countries, workers remove precious metals manually and expose themselves to hazardous material. In developing countries, what happens in developing countries? In developing countries, workers removes precious metals. They remove precious metals manually, and they expose themselves to hazardous waste, and then they expose themselves to various types of hazardous waste here. Okay. So only viable solution of e-waste is recycle. The only viable solution of e-waste is recycle. That is the only solution for e-waste. You know something, that hospital waste, we can do the incineration. For electronic waste, we can do the landfill and the incineration both. Developed countries export more than half of their waste to the developing countries. And in developing countries, workers remove the precious metal from this e-waste manually, and they expose themselves to hazardous metals. Okay. which causes lots and lots of problems later on. So the only solution is for e-waste is recycling. Clear? And now we are going to study about case study on solid waste. So this is all about the solid waste. And now the case study is very, very important here. Okay? So we are going to study about case study on solid waste. Next topic is case study on solid waste. What is the case study on solid waste here? Plastic. Here you will study about plastic. Okay. A 57-year-old Ahmed Khan, who was a plastic manufacturer, elaborated. A 57-year-old man, Ahmed Khan. Here you will talk about a man, Ahmed Khan. Okay. He elaborated RV College of Engineering. Okay, he elaborated RV College of Engineering. Engineering. Okay, and this college is in and Bangalore City Corporation. And Bangalore City Corporation. Bangalore City Corporation. Okay. He gave Polybland, fine powder of recycled modified plastic, to this college. What he gave? He gave Polybland. What is Polybland? Fine powder. It is a fine powder of recycled modified plastic. Of recycled, modified, recycled, modified plastic to the college. He gave Polybland to the college. Okay. He said, mix Polybland with bitumen and make roads. What he said? Mix Polybland with bitumen. And then use the mixture for making roads. Okay. These types of roads, life increases 3 times and also more resistant to water. These types of roads, life increases 3 times and these roads are more resistant to water as compared to any normal road. Okay. So more than 40 kilometers of roads in Bangalore. More than 40 kilometer roads are made in this way only. So what is the case study here? A 57-year-old man, Ahmed Khan, he elaborated the RV College of Engineering and Bangalore City Corporation. He gave them Polybland, a fine powder of modified and recycled plastic. And he told them to mix Polybland with bitumen and start making roads. These roads are much more stronger and more resistant to water. And now in Bangalore, more than 40 kilometer roads are made in this method only. Okay. Next, we are going to study about agrochemical waste. Next topic is agrochemical waste. Here only I will explain it. Space is there. Agrochemical waste. Agrochemical waste. Okay. Example, pesticides, insecticides, fertilizers, etc. So these agrochemicals run off into water bodies and add nutrients. Okay. Example is pesticides, then fertilizers, etc. Okay. So what will happen? These types of fertilizers run off into water bodies and add nutrients. It adds nutrients. Okay, and then due to these nutrients, plant will grow more and die more. Okay, so plant due to these nutrients, plants will grow and die more and more. Okay, as a result, to decompose the dead bodies, aerobic bacteria consume oxygen and reduces dissolved oxygen. I told you about this. Then the aerobic bacteria will decompose these dead bodies. Bacteria will decompose the dead bodies of plants by using oxygen, and dissolved oxygen decreases in water. Also, agrochemical waste causes accelerated eutrophication of water bodies. It also causes accelerated eutrophication of water bodies. This is the second effect. Okay, and it also causes biomagnification. It also causes biomagnification. Clear? And then some insecticides kill harmless beneficial insects. Some insecticides kills harmless or beneficial insects. So this is the harmful effect of using agrochemical waste. See, these waste, they run off into the water bodies. Okay, they will add more nutrients will grow more plants. If more plants will grow, more plants will die also. So to decompose these dead bodies, aerobic bacteria will consume all the oxygen of the water. As a result, dissolved oxygen will decrease and fishes will die. This is the first case. Second one is it causes accelerated eutrophication. The more and more amount of dead plant bodies will keep on increasing the layer. And as a result, they will make the lake shallow and dry land. Okay. Third is biomagnification. These are non-biodegradable. So they will keep on increasing along with the food chain. Okay. And some insecticides lead to the death of some beneficial and harmless insects. Okay. So, less amount of dissolved oxygen in water bodies, then accelerated eutrophication, then biomagnification, and the death of some beneficial insects are the harmful effects of using agrochemical waste. Okay, now what is the case study? Now we'll study about case study of agrochemical waste. Case study of agrochemical waste. Case study of agrochemical waste. Okay. So here, Ramesh Chandra Dagar from Sonipat. Ramesh Chandra Dagar from Sonipat in Haryana. Okay. Makes Haryana Kisan Welfare Club. He makes Haryana Kisan Welfare Club. Okay. And decides to do organic farming. He decides to do organic farming. He decides to do beekeeping. He decides to do beekeeping also. Okay. Dairy management and agriculture. Okay. Now what will happen? By doing the dairy management will produce the cow dung. Okay. And this cow dung can be used for agriculture purpose. It is used for agriculture. Okay. In the form of manure. Okay. मैनेजमेंट, डेयरी मैनेजमेंट काउ डंग और डंग और सिंपली डंग. इट कैन बी यूज फॉर बायोगैस विच इज अ एनर्जी सोर्स. इट कैन बी ऑल्सो यूज फॉर बायोगैस. ओके, देन एग्रीकल्चरल वेस्ट. द एग्रीकल्चरल वेस्ट, एग्रीकल्चरल वेस्ट, ओके, इट कैन बी यूज फॉर, एग्रीकल्चरल वेस्ट कैन बी यूज फॉर द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ कंपोस्टिंग. कंपोस्टिंग, कंपोस्टिंग इज अ टाइप ऑफ मैन्योर. ओके, सो एंड सो बेसिकली ही वॉज डूइंग सस्टेनेबल एग्रीकल्चर. बेसिकली ही वॉज डूइंग सस्टेनेबल एग्रीकल्चर, द टाइप ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर इन विच एनवायरमेंट इज नॉट हार्म्ड. तो टूडे 5,000 फार्मर्स हैव जॉइन दिस क्लब. टूडे 5,000 फार्मर्स हैव जॉइंड दिस क्लब. सो टू रेड्यूस द डिपेंडेंस ऑन एग्रीकल्चरल वेस्ट, रमेश चंद्र डागर फ्रॉम सोनीपत हरियाणा, ही डिड द फॉलोइंग थिंग्स. ही मेड हरियाणा किसान वेलफेयर क्लब. ही डिड ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग, बी कीपिंग, डेयरी मैनेजमेंट, एग्रीकल्चर एक्सेट्रा. बाय डूइंग द डेयरी मैनेजमेंट, द डंग प्रोड्यूस्ड हियर कैन बी यूज्ड इन एग्रीकल्चर एज मैन्योर. द डंग कैन ऑल्सो बी यूज फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ बायोगैस. देन एग्रीकल्चरल वेस्ट कैन बी यूज टू सिंथेसाइज मैन्योर दैट इज कंपोस्ट. सो बेसिकली ही वॉज डूइंग सस्टेनेबल एग्रीकल्चर एंड टूडे मोर देन 5,000 farmers have joined this club. So this is the case study of agrochemical waste. Okay, very nice work he is doing. Okay, next is radioactive waste. Radioactive waste. So what is radioactive waste? We all know very well about this. Radioactive waste releases harmful radiations which causes death in high doses. It releases harmful radiations. Okay, radioactive waste releases harmful radiations. It releases harmful radiations which causes death in heavy doses. And it causes death in heavy doses. It causes death in heavy doses. Okay. And mutation also it causes in low doses, which leads to cancer. And it causes mutation in low doses, which leads to cancer. Which leads to cancer. So radioactive waste produces harmful radiations which causes death in heavy doses, and it causes mutations in low doses which leads to cancer. Now problems with nuclear energy. What are the problems with nuclear energy? Problems with nuclear energy. Problems with nuclear energy. Although nuclear energy is a symbol of a developed country, but it causes many, many harmful effects also. For example, accidental leakage. Sometimes it got leak by accident. Accidental leakage. Leakage. And the second problem here is the disposal, waste disposal. How to dispose? Waste disposal. So these are the main problems with the nuclear energy. Sometimes they leaked, that is accidental leakage, and so sometimes the problem is with their disposal. First one is accidental leakage. Example, Chernobyl and Three Mile Island. Example is Chernobyl and Three Mile Island. Three Mile Island, okay, are the places where accidental leakage takes place. So these are the places, two places where accidental leakage took place. Waste disposal, make a 500 meter dig on land. First, make a 500 meter dig on land. Okay, put a vessel and dump radioactive waste. Put a vessel into dig, okay, and then dump radioactive waste. Dump radioactive waste here, okay, in that vessel. So this is not an appropriate way, but this is also not an appropriate way. Waste in vessel, first, second, third. Okay, so accidental leakage example is Chernobyl and Three Mile Island. So these are the two places where new accidental leakage took place. Okay, then how you can dispose the radioactive waste? First, make a 500 meter dig on land, then put a vessel in that dig, and then dump the radioactive waste in that vessel. But this method is also not appropriate method. So students, in solid waste, we studied about the how to dump the solid waste, that is either by sanitary landfill or by open dumping and burning. Then we studied the disposal method of biomedical waste, e-waste, okay. Then we studied the case study of plastic, agrochemical waste, case study of agrochemical waste and radioactive waste. So students, that's all for today. Today we have completed the solid waste topics also. So we will meet with the last topic of this chapter. So if you like the video, press the bell icon. And that's all for today, students. Have a nice day to all. Thank you so much.